what it should contain. We are not trying to reinvent the wheel. The United Nations has already come up with a manual of what a portal is expected to do. We will subscribe to that. That way, it is subject to peer review, including by yourselves. So that is why, in a sense, we're also promoting it to you. You please look at it, examine it, discuss it, critique it, and let us know what you think about it. No one is perfect, and I'm sure there's a lot more we can improve based on your needs, since you are the clientele we hope to serve. So right now we're at version 3.0. The first version was unrolled when the President gave his first State of the Nation address. We had our second version last year. This is our shifting to the portal, and you'll notice if we only had a better projection system, but you can all access this. I'm sure some of you can access it right now or when you get home. There's some features we'd just like to point out to show you how there's something in it for everyone. We're very proud of the clean look and design. That's the aesthetic side of things. We're trying to make it relevant, as you see, for different sectors, whether you're a citizen, whether you're in government, whether you want to invest, whether you're a tourist, the information will be categorized and presented according to your needs. You'll be able to find out what your government is doing, what they have to say about things, what regulations are being issued as they are announced, in a manner that is useful to you in many ways. Give you an example. If you were looking up a set of regulations from the government department or by the president, it will be there in HTML, so you can copy and paste and use it for your reports or study. There will be an authenticated PDF, which should be okay for most lawyerly purposes and to cross-check, because of course what you encode is subject to human error, and there must be a controlling document that is the defining document. And there is a cross-match to what has been published in the official gazette. So any person who is a perfectionist can triangulate any issuance, both for your safety and security and for ours, meaning you can cross-check. There are, of course, we're very proud of our statistics. We average about 10 to 18,000 visitors a day. We found out that this has been a very useful service for the media, for researchers, even for fellow members in government and around the world. And again, we're able to do this because the servers are always up and running and the technological back end of things is professionally and efficiently run. We're trying to address all platforms, so you should be able to access it on your Android phone, on your iPhone, on your laptop, and let us know if it doesn't work, in a way that is clean and accessible. And there's something in it for practically all ages and all interests. Just wanted to focus on some things to promote to you. We are deeply committed to getting people to understand how things work. One of the reasons why we have such a very noisy climate is everyone has an opinion, but what is the basis of your opinion? What we are aiming for is an informed public opinion. How your systems work, who is accountable, where is the money going, and how is it kept track of? Who has authority and responsibility for what? So we can do it for anything from how the Chief Justice is appointed to how impeachment works, what is it, what is the logic behind it. We do this through infographics, which are downloadable or viewable in English and Filipino. We're able to explain complex government policies like the K-12 program in an accessible manner through these infographics. And briefers. There's education, because the foundation of a sense of community is a shared identity. that includes your history. Yeah, pardon me, a little bias there, because this is one of the reasons we felt very much that there had to be a government portal. What are we celebrating on Independence Day? What is it about? It goes to your accessing the information across many ways, a timeline by date with enriched media, from documents to pictures to music to video. Students can use it, you can use it, your teachers can use it, you can recommend it to foreigners who want to know what this is all about. And this has never been done before in this manner. And again, most of it open source, so we're not paying through the nose for the technology, and it is in many ways more secure and verifiable to all of you that it works. And again, this is a point we're trying to make, that it does not have to cost a fortune. It requires you to use your coconut, apply it in a manner aimed to your audience and not your own pocket. So, finally, this is perhaps the most nosebleed portion of the thing for anyone in government, because it is what the public wants and expects. But the devil is really in the details. And we're trying to basically make the test a system where you can adopt the best practices of the private sector in terms of getting public complaints, feedback, questions, and attending to them in a manner that doesn't drive everyone crazy, including the person who wants the information. So it involves, for example, a simple ticketing system. And in a sense, this is a dry run for when freedom of information becomes a law, because you should be able to make a request and keep track of where it's going in the process. That involves having a ticket, whether it's virtual or real, and figuring out where it's going. So we're starting this in a small way with our office, and if this works, we have something to roll out for everyone else. Very quick plug as I conclude this afternoon, encouraging you to visit our other websites. Of course, our website, get to know about our office and its horrible acronym. Get to know about what we're doing, just visit us on bcdspo.gov.ph. We also handle the Presidential Museum and Library website. Those of you who have kids, this is a place where they can get good grades by looking at the access. Accessing the information we provide on the presidency of Malacañang. You have a friend, a visitor, you want to go on a tour of the Malacañang Museum, go here, book your appointment. Students have to do reports or access any information on the president or our previous presidents or Malacañang, you can go here. You can stay in touch with us and find out what we're doing on Twitter and on Facebook, and we'll be rolling out Tumblr very soon. We're trying to cover all demographics. And that's my presentation. Thank you very much for giving us the time today. And please let us know what you think.
Thank you very much, Mr. Quezon. It is very good to know that we have this kind of initiative in the government to make everyone be heard. Just a reminder again, we're very sorry that we cannot accommodate all questions as of now. But if you do have questions, please text them to 0917-538-9971.